Good evening, my dear friends, and welcome to Monday evening prayer, the traditional office of Vespers, because today, January the 22nd, is a day of prayer for the legal protection of unborn children. But I also want to share it with the owner of that 12-year-old disabled dog, Meg, that was left on the snowy mountains of Scotland to die. I've had a horrific day just thinking about that poor little dog, just being left, and how callous are some people towards God's little creatures. So moving on, we just give thanks to God for those who do care for God's little creatures and for God's creation. So we light this light this evening and we give thanks to God for those who are compassionate, for those who are loving, and for those who give shelter and rescue to God's defenseless little creatures like Francis of Assisi, and to our brothers and sisters in our community who reach out above and beyond the call of duty to support sick and abandoned animals. Amen. Excuse me. So now we begin with the office of Vespers. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And now we come into the presence of God's love, and we join hands together across the great ocean, the great pond, and we celebrate our love of God together. Okay. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And our hymn this evening, oops, I forgot to welcome you. Welcome to Sister Sue, who's joined us, and those not logged in on live stream. Welcome to our dear brother Kaj, to Amir, to Matthew, to Magdalena, to Sister Mary, to Paul, to Yolanthe. And it's good to have you all join with us this evening. So now we resume the hymn. Praise to the holiest in the height, and in the depth be praise, in all his words most wonderful, more sure are all his ways. O loving wisdom of our God, when all was sin and shame, a second Adam to the fight and to the rescue came. O wisest love, that flesh and blood, which did in Adam fail, should strive afresh against their foe, should strive and should prevail. And that a higher gift and grace should flesh and blood refine, God's presence and his very self and essence all divine. O generous love, that he who smote in man for man the foe, the doubt, the double agony in man for man should undergo, and in the garden secretly and on the cross on high, should teach his brethren and inspire to suffer and to die. Praise to the holiest in the height, and in the depth be praise, in all his words most wonderful, most sure are all his ways. And now the first antiphon, the Lord's revelation to my master, sit on my right. And now we read Psalm 109. The Lord's revelation to my master, sit on my right. Your foes I will put beneath your feet. The Lord will yield from Zion your scepter of power. Rule in the midst of all your foes. A prince from the day of your birth, on the holy mountains, from the womb before the dawn, I begot you. The Lord has sworn an oath, he will not change. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. The master standing at your right hand will shatter kings in the day of his wrath. He shall drink from the stream by the wayside, and therefore he shall lift up his head. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord's revelation to my master. Sit on my right. Alleluia. The second antiphon, the Lord is full of merciful love. He makes us remember his wonders. Alleluia. And now we continue with Psalm 110. I will thank the Lord with all my heart in the meeting of the just in the assembly. Great are the works of the Lord to be pondered by all who love them. Majestic and glorious are his work. His justice stands firm forever. He makes us remember his wonders. The Lord is compassion and love. He gives food to those who fear him, keeps his covenant ever in mind. He has shown his might to his people by giving them the lands of the nations. His works are justice and truth, his precepts, all of them sure, standing firm forever and ever. They are made in uprightness and truth. He has sent deliverance to his people and established his covenant forever. Holy his name to be feared. To fear the Lord is the first stage of wisdom. All who do so prove themselves wise. His praise shall last forever. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord is full of merciful love. He makes us remember his wonders. Alleluia. And now we have the third antiphon, the Lord our God Almighty is King. Alleluia. And now we read from a canticle from the book of Revelation. Alleluia, salvation and glory and power belong to our God. His judgments are true and just. Alleluia. Alleluia, praise our God, all you his servants, you who fear him, small and great. Alleluia. Alleluia, the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. Let us rejoice and exult and give him the glory. Alleluia. Alleluia, the marriage of the Lamb has come, and his bride has made herself ready. Alleluia. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let me read that again. And now we repeat, the Lord our God, the Almighty reigns. Alleluia. And now we have a reading from 1 Peter. Blessed be the God and Father, Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in their great mercy has given us a new birth as their sons and daughters by raising Jesus Christ from the dead, so that we have a sure hope and the promise of an inheritance that can never be spoiled or soiled and never fade away, because it has been kept for you in the heavens. Through your faith, God's power will guard you until the salvation which has been prepared is revealed at the end of time. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the short responsory: Blessed are you, O Lord, in the vault of heaven. Blessed are you, O Lord, in the vault of heaven. You are exalted and glorified above all else forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, in the vault of heaven. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. Blessed are you, O Lord, in the vault of heaven. And just bear with me a moment while I close that and open this. And now, our Benedictine Magnificat Antiphon: The Spirit of the Lord rests upon all of us here. He has sent us to preach God's gospel to the poor. Now, let us join each other in the beautiful canticle of Mary, the Magnificat. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, who is my Savior. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength, and he scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones, and he exalts the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, and he sends the rich away empty-handed. He protects Israel, his servant, you and me, and those of us who've surrendered our heart to God, as he promised to our fathers Abraham and his sons forever. Let us pray together the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And now we repeat the antiphon. Okay, where are we? The Spirit of the Lord rests upon all of us here, for God has sent you and I to go and preach their gospel to the poor. And now we come to that time where we bring our own intercessions or requests to our God, the God of many names and none. God is ever creative. God's love renews all things and is the source of our hope. Let us turn to God in confidence as we pray. Response: Lord, accept our thanks and praise. Lord, accept our thanks and prayers. We give thanks for the order of created beings and things. You have blessed us with the resources of the earth and the gift of human life. Response: Lord, accept our thanks and prayers. We pray for all the nations of the world. May those in authority work for peace and the goodwill among all men and women. Response: Lord, accept our thanks and prayers. We pray for all who are homeless this evening. We pray for families searching for a place to live, and for refugees driven from their homeland, like the Rohingya refugees and the Syrian refugees and so many others. We pray for them and the little ones in this cold weather. Life was your first gift to us. May those who have died come to its fullness in you. But let us now bring our own requests. As we sit in the presence of God, a God who is love, who is all merciful and all forgiving, but who abhors cruelty to God's little ones and to God's creatures, for they are perceived as acts of violence, even directed at God. So let us now name, bless, and release to God whatever may be heavy on our heart. And let us now sense the peace of the loving, living God. This evening, I want to bring each one of you gathered here. You've given up your quality time to join me. The least I can do is to bring you by name into the presence of a loving God. We bring dear Sue and our friend Kath, and we bring all the brothers and sisters of our community around the world, but especially we bring those who are hurting, unwell, and who are struggling, for Mother Olivia, with Brother Matthew, who both have raised blood pressures. We pray for both of them. We pray for all our brothers and sisters around the world who reach out to God's defenseless little creatures and who rescue so many abandoned animals, like Sister Eleanor in Philadelphia, where stray cats always seem to come knocking on their little door, and where they offer them sanctuary and love. To Sister Miriam in New Zealand, who is just a beautiful hermit, and who gives so much love to creation and to God's little creatures, and to here in our little monastery with our rescued hens and doves, and so many other beautiful creatures that come into our garden. We pray for Sister Mary in Michigan, who also is another St. Francis with God's little creatures. And for Sister Sandra, for Brother Kaj and Sister Paula. We pray this evening for Ray, who's joined us, with Amir from Derry, good old Amir. For Matthew, for Sister Magdalena, Sister Mary, Paul, good evening, dear Paul, Yolanthe, Monique, Beverly Peterson, good evening, dear Beverly, for Dana Lungehagen, for Gisela Barry, welcome, Gisela, for dear Rita and Magdalena. And Mary has left a message: the Holy Spirit is helping me with the prayer. With the Praise the Lord proclamation for the Franciscan Sanctuary of Hope in the UK and the United States, where we all praise and speak, declare the Franciscan Sanctuary of Hope into existence. Wow, well done. Oh, that's such a beautiful, you've lifted me out of the pits of despair, because I've been so sad since reading that email from Brother Chris this morning, where we all prayed for Meg, the disabled dog left on a snowy mountain in Scotland, and then a drone found it dead where its owner had left it to die. Oh, I've just been crushed thinking of someone doing that to a defenseless little creature. We remember Ida and dear Reverend Bishop John Chapman. Bless you. Bless you all for being here. Well, let us close our eyes just for a moment as we come into the presence of love. And let us give thanks to God for the many gifts that we have received today or will receive from God's loving hands. So let us be still just be still for a moment and sense the peace of God. And I dedicate
you are forever telling me I'm weak, when I'm criticized, I never speak. I prefer to turn the other cheek, but I will love you all my life. I can never do things right by you. I'm the kind of man who muddles through. You can find mistakes in all I do, but I will love you all my life. Something foolish happens. Have you seen in the middle of it all? There's me. Seems I caused you so much misery, but I will love you all my life.
So let us, all the days of our life, allow the wonderful God who has many names and none, come into our hearts and to fill us with the peace, the love, and the joy, and the inner knowing that we are already loved. So let us receive from the hands of a loving God, the benediction, the blessing, to free us from all negativity, all fear, all anxiety or discouragement, and let us just give thanks. Give thanks to God for all that we receive. And we send love, light, and blessing today on this day of prayer for the protection of all those unborn children, and on Meg's owner for doing the most horrific thing to his 12-year-old disabled dog and leaving her to die in the snow on the snowy mountains of Scotland. We pray for his soul, and we pray for all those who abuse God's little creatures. Amen. So let us now, in the silence of our heart, say the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, Mother God, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us at this hour our daily bread. Forgive us our disobedience, our selfishness, impatience, stubbornness. Lead us not astray, O Lord, but protect us from those hurtful influences and negative forces and mindsets that seek to trap us. Deliver us from all evil and protect us, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And from our little book of Celtic prayers from Iona, we come now to the closing prayer. I end this day as the Son of Mary would end it. The grace of God be on this place and on all whom God has given to me, who keeps watch this night over us, who but the Christ of our love. And as I blow out this flame, I say thank you, God. Thank you for touching each of our hearts and for filling us with your peace, your love, your joy, and not to lose heart. Amen. So go in peace to love and to serve our God. Namaste, Shalom, Inshallah, Pax et Bonum, OmShanti, Solo di Caritas, Salam Alaikum, and may the peace of the Son of Peace become your peace, God's prayer partners for peace. I wish you all a beautiful day over there in America. And I wish the rest of us here in Europe a pleasant warm evening. Good night, and God bless you all till we meet again around this table of love. Bless your hearts.
I do.